You know, I think in Matthew chapter 13, there was a parable Jesus said. He said that there was a man who was working in a man's farm, and he saw a treasure in the land. So when he saw the treasure, he went and sold everything he had so that he can get that treasure. You can go and buy the field and get the treasure in the field. So in that parable, what was Jesus saying? That a man was working in a farm. He saw a treasure in the farm or the field. And because he wanted the treasure in the field, he went and sold everything that he had so that he can buy the field, so that he can get the treasure in the field. In this parable, the man that went to sold everything he had was Jesus. Jesus was talking about himself. Because he loved the treasure that was in the field, he went to sell everything he had to get the treasure. So, what is the treasure? What is the field? The field was the world. The treasure is you and I. Because Jesus saw us that we are treasurable. We are so important to him. He came and gave himself, sold himself, everything of himself, so that he would die for you and I. So that through his death, he can have you and I to himself. That was what the parable Jesus said. That a man went to sell everything he had to buy the field so that he can get the treasure. So the whole world has been bought. It's just that a man has to believe in him to come to him. That's why the Bible said that we are bought with a price. So what price did Jesus buy us? With his precious blood. With his precious blood. He shed his blood on the cross to have you and I. So because he deemed us that we are so treasurable to him. Beloved, you are so treasurable. God loves you so much. He just wants you to come to this revelation of his love. Don't let people tell you that unless you love God enough, unless you do this enough, unless you have not prayed enough, you have not given enough, you have not done this enough, until you are able to do that before God loves you. That is not true of scripture. Jesus did not love people. Jesus did not love the guy on the cross because the guy did anything good. By the law, his trespasses, he would never deserve to have gone to the kingdom of God. Because he needed to make restitution for himself. He had to go back to the people he had stolen, tell them he was sorry. But Jesus was the one that paid for his trespasses on the cross. So Jesus said that today, you'll be with me in paradise. The man just had to believe. So Jesus loved the man so much that he died for him on the cross, that the man can be saved. Beloved, God wants you to know today, have a fresh revelation of his love for you. He loves you so much. He loves you so much. He wants you to just be on your bed, be on your sofa, just meditating on how much he has loved you, how much you are undeserving, but yet he loves you. Yet he gave his all to have you. If you go through the gospel, you see how much Jesus loved people who didn't deserve, like I've said earlier. And you always see that those people who realized that they didn't deserve, they came back pouring love onto other people. They came back rejoicing, praising God, now having a revelation to love God. There was something happening in the Bible.